Hi, I am Muralidharan. I am very great pleasure to meet you again. My channel name is Murali HR and hope you are all subscribed in this channel. Today I am going to talk about termination of employment. First of all, our Constitution of India, how it scope the termination of employment. In the Article 21, there is a clause, protection of life and liberty. In this clause, if we want to terminate an employee, there is a cause to terminate an employee. That is detailed in so many cases heard by the High Court as well as in the Supreme Court. And as well as in the same manner, in the Article 19.1G, there is a fundamental right has been given to the employer. He can practice any profession or any business is given under the given as a fundamental right. Coming to the Industrial Dispute Act, a retrenchment definition has been given. Under that, the retrenchment in the establishment, except on VRS, retirement, non-renewal of contract and ill health is excluded in the retrenchment. And in the severance clause, that is under the, like we are paying the notice period and we are terminating an employee, will also be the termination. And if we are terminating an employee for misconduct, like habitual absence, theft or insubordination, like that there are various misconduct are defined under the Industrial Standing Order Act. That is also comes under the termination of. And breach clause, if an employee working under an organization, he has signed it in the appointment order, and there are so many clauses in the appointment order. If he breaches the clauses in the employment appointment order, that will also come under the breach clause. The workmen under the ID Act must be dealt under the Chapter 5A and 5B. Chapter 5A, if we are retrenching an employee, he must be given 1 month notice and 15 days wage for every year of service, and we have to give the notice to the government. And if we come to on 5B, we have to give a 3 months notice period and 15 days wage for every year of service to an employee. And if we case the case law, Intertech India versus Priyanga Mohan, she was working as a salesman under that one retail shop at Mumbai, and she has been terminated without having a cause. Since then he has asked so many times with that manager of the seller of own garments, and that seller has not agreed for reinstatement of an employee. Then she filed a complaint before the conciliation as well as in the court. Court upheld that if we are terminating an employee without any cause, will cause for reinstatement. That is defined in the Intertech India versus Priyanka Mohan case. So we must give an appointment order before an appointment of on any employee. That will protect the employer, because we will state the breach of contract with the conditions. If you are terminating an employee, in many organizations we will impose 3 months notice or 1 month notice, like that. And we are also stating about the age factor, and we are also stating about the designation and when we are terminating an employee and other thing. And there is one more thing in the case of managerial and supervisory cadre. And there are many departments in an organization, like engineering and R&D and lab and other departments. There are people are moving from one organization to other, and they may leak out the secrets and trade secrets and other thing. So there are so many restrictive clauses are there in the appointment order. If an employee breaches the restrictive clauses, whether that will affect his termination or employer may terminate at any point of time, when he comes to know that if an employee has steal the their trade secrets and all. In one case, Niranjan Golikari versus Century Spinning Mill, the Supreme Court of India stated that if an employee has left the organization, and if an employer show in the court that he has stolen the trade secret and other thing, will not sustain for on behalf of them, because if an employee rendering the services to only to safeguard the employer, and during the employment the employer may protest that he has stolen the trade secret and he has doing the job against the competition, trade competition and other thing. In other cases, if he has left on employment, he cannot, the employer cannot show before the court for his action and other thing. That is defined in the Supreme Court. And in the G Telefilm case, what are all the breach of restrictive convenience? That is detailed in that case. If an employee working against the confidential, working in a confidential position, if he has done a job of breaching the contract, means that will come under the breach of restrictive convenient. And he has obligation to maintain the confidence of the of an organization. If he has breached that confidence, then he will be booked under the breach of restrictive convenient. And if an employee detrimental to the nature of an organization, that will also come under the breach of restrictive convenience. So these are all the items detailed in the G Telefilm case. And one more thing, we are nowadays dismissing an employee because of loss of confidence. If in the Supreme Court case law, Kankayalal Agarwal versus factory manager, in that case, there are three occasions the employee may cause for loss of booked under the loss of confidence. That is, trust of confidence, act or commit to for future his employment, detrimental on employment, detrimental to his employment nature. So, and sexual, these are all the things to be taken into consideration before dismissing an employee. That is highlighted in the Kankayalal Agarwal versus factory manager case. And what are all the areas which will be under the loss of confidence? Sexual harassment, breach of confidentiality, incompetent, theft and misappropriation will come under the loss of confidence. So if we are terminating an employee either for non-solicited trade clause or non-competition or non-competition and non-confidential trade secret leakages, before that we have to see to that if an employee has done a mistake on these areas, we have to prove that he has done a leak out the trade secret or he has a breach of contract under these three classes. Otherwise, if an workman has done a misconduct, we have to go in line with the standing order. So this is what, this is the way we have to handle the termination areas. Thank you, and I would like to subscribe under the Murali HR channel. Thank you. I will meet you once again.